Hello. In this video, we will solve one problem, that is find I1 of 0 minus I2 of 0 minus I1 of 0 plus and I2 of 0 plus in this circuit and get an expression for I1 of t. It should be I1 of t. So two currents here, one current which is passing through this 2 ohm resistance, that is nothing but I1. Another current I2 which is passing through this 5 ohm, that is I2. So we have to find these quantities, and there is a switch at t equal to 0. Switch will be closed, before that it is opened, and we have one voltage source here and one current source here. Okay, and looking at this circuit, one thing we can do, this current source in parallel with the resistance, using source transformation, we can replace it by a voltage source in series with the resistance. So instead of current source parallel resistance, from source transformation, we can replace it by one voltage source and in series with the resistance. Okay. So we will first write circuit for t less than 0 and switch is opened before t equal to 0. So we will first write this voltage source, that is 1 volt, and we will replace this current source by a battery and in series with the resistance. And what is the magnitude of that voltage source? That is nothing but I into R, 100 milli into 20, that is 2000 milli, that is nothing but 2 volt. So this is 2 volt and resistance is same, series resistance 20, and this is 5, this is 2, and there is a capacitor across this, that is 2 micro and 3 ohm, and I1 of t here and I2 of t, and current switch is open, so that will not come into picture. Now at t equal to 0, this capacitor, or the t equal to 0 minus capacitor, will be acting like open circuit. Okay, so that we will see in the analysis, we will consider that one. Now one more circuit diagram we will draw, that is for t greater than 0. That time this we will retain, the source transformation we will retain, but this switch is closed. So all the current flows through like this only, from this. So no current flows through other part of circuit, that is 5 and 2, this is 5, 2 and 3, and here you have capacitor initially at t equal to 0 plus, it can be considered as a voltage source. Okay, so 2 microfarad. And current passing through this is I1 and this one is I2 and this one is 21 volt. Okay, this is t greater than 0. Once we have this circuit, step one, we will first find out I1 of 0 minus, that is this circuit we have to see. But one thing in this, at t equal to 0 minus, this capacitor will act like a open circuit. So no current flows through this capacitor. So the current I2, whatever current flowing through 5 ohm resistor, same current flows through 2 ohm resistor also. So I2 is equal to I1. So I1 of 0 minus is nothing but I2 of 0 minus, and that is equal to, how to calculate now, since it is open circuit, what is the current flowing through this 5 ohm and 2 ohm resistance, that you have to apply KVL in this circuit. This is a KVL if you apply. This is 3 volt battery, they are in series. And one thing you have to do here, I think one mistake is there, just check here. This arrow mark is toward this side. So this 2 volt, it should be, this should be plus and this should be minus. This should be plus and this should be minus, because arrow, towards arrow, positive sign. So same thing you have to do here also. This side positive, this side negative. So that one mistake is there, you correct it. Since arrow mark is toward this side, plus sign should be this side. Plus here, minus here. Same thing here, plus here, minus here. Okay. Now, this 2 volt and 3 volt, they are in series. So add those two battery, then it become 3 volt. And total resistance of the circuit loop is 20 plus 5, 25, 27 and 30. So total voltage is 30. Total voltage is 3 volt. Total resistance is 31. So 3 by 30 if you do, it is, so I1 of 0 equal to I2 of 0, it is 3 divided by 30. That is nothing but 0.1 ampere you will get. That is I1 of 0 and I2 of 0. At t equal to 0 minus, both currents are same. Okay. Now we will calculate VC of 0 minus also. It is not asked, but we need that one for getting expression for I1 of t. Okay. What is VC of 0 minus? So VC of voltage across this 2 ohm resistor. What is that? You know the current passing through that resistance. You know the resistance value. Then you can easily find out voltage, open circuit voltage across this 2 ohm. That is 2 into 0.1. So that is nothing but 0.2 volt. This is step 1. Step 2, we will calculate at t equal to 0 plus. Better we will write once again the circuit at t equal to 0 plus. At t equal to 0 plus, which is closed here. So this part of circuit I no need to write. Only this part of circuit required. So we have 1.5 ohm. And 2 ohm and 3 ohm. But now how to replace this 2 microfarad capacitor? This capacitor should be replaced by, what we have to do that? We have to replace it by a voltage source. So voltage source I have to replace, and we are taking VC of 0 minus like this. VC is this side because current is this side. So we will take VC plus and VC minus is this side, plus is this side. So I have to write same, plus this side, minus this side. Okay. So VC at t equal to 0 plus, this is nothing but a 0.2 volt battery. And this resistance is 2, this resistance is 5, and here it is 3. And this current is passing through I1, and this is I2. Now, first thing we have to write, VC of 0 plus, we should write, that is VC of 0 minus, that is equal to 0.2 volt. So since I know the voltage across 2 ohm resistance cannot change instantaneously, it is 0.2 volt. So I will know the current passing through this resistance also. What is that? I1 of 0 plus is 0.2 volt, that is voltage across 2 ohm resistor divided by 2, that is 0.1 ampere. So current I1 of 0 plus is 0.1 ampere. Now we have to see the I2 here. See, there is a compulsion for this I1 current. Though there is a change in the circuit, the current passing through this is determined by the voltage across this. So what is the voltage across this one? Voltage across this is 0.2, that cannot change instantaneously. So there is a compulsion that I1 has to follow that 0.2 divided by 2, 0.1 micro, 0.1 ampere. But same thing will apply for this I2 also. We will see that one. So now from the KVL we have to calculate. To calculate 2I1, we know the voltage across resistance, that is 0.2 volt. So simply divide by resistance, you will get the current through this 2 ohm resistance. But you want to find the current through 5 ohm, then you have to use the KVL. So KVL if you use, so What is that? From KVL at t equal to 0 plus, at t equal to 0 plus. Okay, so what is that current? I2 current is flowing, I2 of 0 plus into 5, and across 2 ohm, across 2 ohm, I know already the voltage across 2 ohm. What is that? 0.2 volt. So I no need to multiply current by resistance. I know the voltage because there is a voltage across, voltage source across this resistance. It is nothing but a capacitor at t equal to 0 plus. So plus 0.2 volt plus. And what is the current remaining here? 0.2, sorry, I2 current is flowing through the circuit here. Okay. So 3 into I2 of 0 plus. Just see here, I2 of 0 plus is current flowing through here. Current through this resistance is determined by the voltage divided by resistance. And again, the I2 will merge here. So rest current, where it will go? Suppose X current is flowing here. If Y current is flowing through this 2 ohm resistance, so current source, voltage source will take X minus Y. And here they will merge together, and finally you will get the original current, that is I2 current you will get. Okay, so I can show like this. I2 current here. Here there is a branch, it will pass through like this, and again they will merge, and these two again merge, and the same current pass through. So what is the current? I2 will split up here, again merge, the same I2 will flow through 3 ohm also. And when it splits up, this we know, what is the current passing through the resistance, we know. We have to divide voltage by resistance, we will get. Okay. So, that is equal to 0. So, if you solve this one, so you will get I2 of 0 plus is minus 0.2 divided by 8, that is minus 0.025 ampere. So, actual current direction will be, it is minus, so it will be opposite to what we have shown here, actual current. Okay, so that is at t equal to 0 plus. Now, step 3. Okay, step 3 we have to find. Step 3 we have to find R equivalent. So, R equivalent we have to find because we want to find time constant tau. So, what is the R equivalent? In the t greater than 0, that is this circuit, this part I no need to consider because it is cut off, because all the current flows through here, none of the current flows through this one. So this part of circuit I no need to consider. Now only this part is considered, we have to consider in that, what is the equivalent resistance across this capacitor. So you can see that this, across this capacitor we have one resistor 2 ohm, and that is in series with these two. Oh sorry, this 5 and 3 are in parallel with the 2 ohm. Okay, so I will rewrite otherwise. So you have one resistance 2 ohm and capacitance you have here, and here you have 5 ohm and this is 3 ohm. Okay, so I have to find what is the R equivalent. So this 5 and 3 are in series, but they together in parallel with this 2 ohm resistance. So total R equivalent is nothing but 2 parallel 8. So if you calculate, it is 1.6 ohm, you will get. Now what is tau, time constant? Tau is R equivalent into C, that is 1.6 into C is 2 micro, that is 3.2 microsecond. Okay. Now step 4 we have to calculate. So step 4 is, see that in the question what are the things we already found. So question is I1 of 0 minus, done. I2 of 0 minus, done. I1 of 0 plus, done. And I2 of 0 plus also done. We have calculated all the value here. You can see here in the step 2 we calculated I2 of 0 plus also, I1 of 0 plus also. Now step 4, only thing remaining is I1 of t. So I1 of t, it is a source free circuit. See that after t equal to 0, we don't have any source here. Any source we don't have. So it is a source free RC network. So source free RC network. So k into e power minus t by tau. So what you will get here, this is I1 of 0, that is 0 plus. Remember, in this we have to write I1 of 0 plus always. Okay, so I1 of 0 plus, we already know what is that value. I1 of 0 plus, I1 of 0 plus is here 0.1 ampere. So you write that 0.1 ampere. So this is 0.1 ampere. And e power minus t by tau. Tau is 3 point, sorry, t is 0 here. Tau is 3.2 microsecond. So e power 0 here, because at t equal to 0, I am calculating. Sorry. This one is 1 minute. Let me rub this. Okay. So I1 of 0 plus is 0.1. So that is equal to a into e power 0. Directly I can write, because minus t is 0 divided by tau is 3.2. So what we will get is a. So a is 0.1. So a we have calculated, that 0.1. Now in the main equation, we have to find I1 of t is a, we know 0.1, e power minus t by tau. Tau is 3.2. micro. So this is the response we are going to get. So I1 of t is 0.1 into e power minus t by 3.2 micro. Okay.